Hello friends, welcome to One Click Agri YouTube channel. Read the disclaimer of One Click Agri YouTube channel. Now again short briefing of our One Click Agri YouTube channel. We will be providing videos with notes and study material for all agricultural competitive exams. So the outline of our lecture series will be bifurcated into two broad categories. That is 1 lakh agriculture objectives and theory of all agricultural subject. So here you will get subject wise objective along with notes, and we have selected subject agronomy, and we will be continuing it from question number 1 to question number 15. Let's see the question number first. IR8 variety of rice is introduced in India from, the right answer for this question, Philippines. And IR8 variety was introduced in India in 1966. Another, the Depok method of raising seedlings or raising nursery of rice introduced in India from Philippines. The rest of the two options over here, in that the Taiwan, the first dwarf variety of rice developed in the world, that is TN1, that is Taichung native one, please be remember this variety. And zero tillage introduced to the India from USA. The next question. Origin of rice, the right answer for this question, India and Burma. And it is also known as Southeast Asia. This is for the origin of rice and sugarcane. The rest of the three options over here, in that first, Southwest Asia, and this place is origin for the wheat, barley, buckwheat, gram and lucerne. The B option, South America, it means Peru, for the potato, tomato and sunflower. And potato is introduced in India from Europe in 17th century. Please be remember this point. The next question. Which of the following variety is a dwarf mutant? The right answer for this question, Jagannath variety. And it is a mutant of TN141. And another two varieties of rice that are mutant. First is Prabhavati and second Sattari. Please be remember these two varieties. The first option, IR8, this is evolved by the breeder Henry M. Beechel. He was at International Rice Research Institute, Manila, Philippines. And IR8 is crossed between DZU gene into PETA. Please be remember this. And this IR8 variety of rice is salinity tolerant. The rest of the two options over here, in that Jaya, it's evolved by Dr. Shastri. He's the Indian scientist. And Jaya is a intervarietal cross between TN1 into TN141, and this is the first dwarf variety developed in India, and it is also known as miracle rice because it's out yielded IR8 variety. Please be remember this point. And Pusa 221, that is released from IARI New Delhi. The next question. Productivity of rice is highest in, the right answer for this question, Punjab. And the productivity of rice for the kharif crop is 20 quintal per hectare and rabbi 31 quintal per hectare. And the same Punjab state, the wheat productivity 41.79 quintal per hectare. Please be remember this point also. The rest of the three options over here, In that, first is Haryana, the highest wheat and pulses productivity. Uttar Pradesh, highest area and production of wheat and sugarcane. And only the area and productivity of mango is highest in the Uttar Pradesh. The D option, West Bengal, the highest rice producing state and highest area of rice. Please remember this. The next question. The genus Oryza includes, the right answer for this question, 24 species, and in which only the two species, that is Oryza sativa and Oryza glabrima, is cultivable, and rest of the 22 are wild type of species. And in India, Oryza sativa is cultivated, and in the Africa, Oryza glabrima is cultivated. Please be remember these two things. The next question. The seed rate of the rice cultivation in broadcasting and drilling method respectively should be, the right answer for this question, 160 kg per hectare. The another two seed rates of rice, in that hybrid rice seed rate, it's 15 kg per hectare, and for the Depok method, 1.5 to 3 kg per hectare. Please be remember these two. The next question. The rice variety grown in India belongs to, the right answer for this question, Indica, and it is also known as tropical rice, and rest of the two options over here, in that Japonica. It is widely grown in Japan, and it is also known as subtropical rice. And Japonica, in the Japonica, the lodging doesn't occur. Please be remember this point. In Javanica, it is also known as Balu or Balu rice, and this grown in Indonesia, and this is also known as wild rice. Please be remember this. The next question. Non-traditional area of rice cultivation. The right answer for this question, Punjab and Haryana. And it is a traditional area for the wheat. The next question. The rice inflorescence is known as, the right answer for this question, panicle, and lychee and mango inflorescence, also known as the panicle. And spikelet is also known as the head or ear. Wheat and bajra inflorescence, known as the spikelet. And mustard inflorescence, known as silikpa. Please be remember this. Next question. The dehulled rice grain is known as, the right answer for this question, brown rice. And another two options over here. First is the white rice. Second is the red rice. White rice, it is a good source of magnesium, phosphorus, manganese, selenium, iron, folic acid, thiamine and niacin. And the red rice, the consumption of the red and black rice reduces or retards the progression of atherosclerotic plaque development induced by dietary cholesterol in mammals. Please be remember this. The next question. Rice crop needs, the rice crop needs hot and humid climate, and another, black gram also required hot and humid climate. Soybean requires warm and humid climate. Wheat requires cold and dry climate. Pearl millet and green grams required dry and hot climatic condition. The next question. Ripening of rice required temperature should be lies between, the right answer for this question, 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. And this 20 to 25 degrees Celsius temperature is ideal for rice grain group formation, then wheat growth, optimum crop growth of gram, optimum crop growth of sunflower. The rest of the three options over here, 21 to 37 degrees Celsius, the temperature is ideal for the rice growth, and 25 to 29 degrees Celsius, ideal for the rice flowering, and 16 to 20 degrees Celsius is ideal temperature range for the tillering stage in wheat, please be remember this, and 17 to 20 degrees Celsius is ideal for the potato tuberization. In the potato, if temperature exceed 30 degrees Celsius, there won't be tuberization, so that the required temperature is 17 to 20 degrees Celsius. Please be remember this. The next question. Photoperiodically rice is, the right answer for this question, short day. And another examples of the short day plants are sorghum, bajra, field pea and soybean. And already we have discussed short day, long day and day neutral plants in the horticultural lecture series. So that please go and watch all the horticultural lecture series. Long day plants, in that the wheat, barley and gram, and day neutral, that is grown throughout the year, in that the maize, gram, groundnut and sunflower. The next question. The sowing time of os rice is, the right answer for this question, May, June, as per the given options. And os rice is also known as autumn rice or pre-kharif rice. Please be remember these two names of the os rice. And the sowing time of pre-kharif rice is April, May. As sometimes you'll find the May, June, but as per the option, you should have to choose the right answer. If you will find May, June in the option and April, May in the another option, then you definitely go for the April, May. And if you won't see the May, April, May in the option, then you definitely go for the May, June. And the harvesting time of os and autumn rice is August and September. Please be remember this. In the November and December, the boro, or is also known as spring or summer rice, also is sowing. Sometimes you will find the January, February months. Please be remember these two options. And the harvesting of boro rice in April and May. In June, July, aman, kharif or agani rice is sown. And the harvesting of aman rice in the October. Please be remember the harvesting dates of particular rice. And the one note is here. In the northwest part of the country, only kharif crop is taken. Please be remember this. The next question. The optimum pH of soil varies between for the rice cultivation. The right answer for this question, 4 to 6. And the another two crops are grown in that particular soil pH range, that are tea and tobacco. The another pH range is 6 to 7, in that carrot, onion, beetroot and roots. Another one is 5 to 6.5 in that millet and cotton. Another 7 to 9 in that the 7 to 7.5 for the marigolds and 7.5 to 8 for the cluster bean. Please watch lecture number 2. And now it's time to subscribe, like and share our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get latest video notification. Thank you for being with us. See you soon in next lecture. Bye-bye.